Hello dear children, this is Pavitra, SA Bioscience from ZPHS Gaddipalli, Gaddipalli Mandal. Today I am going to discuss about the topic from cell, its structure and functions. Before entering into the topic, please think about these questions. You already learn about these questions. What is the structural and functional unit of living beings, children? Structure means, a structural unit means entire body is made up of them only, made up of those units only. Functional means those units perform particular specific functions. Because of that units only, entire organism works. So what are they? Structural and functional units of living beings are cells. What are the organelles present in a cell? Organelles means little organs. Little organs are the membrane bound organs present in the cell. Organelles. Okay. What are the organelles present inside the cell? Mitochondria, nucleus, ribosomes, lysosomes, vacuoles. Those are all the organelles present in a cell. What could be the structure of organelles? How they are made up of? What are the functions of different organelles present in a cell? We have seen about the nucleus and its functions in the previous class. It is the nucleus is the important organelle of the cell. It contains genetic material. It controls all other functions of the cell. And it is the reason for our characteristics. What the color of skin, the color of eyeball and the hair color and the words we are producing, the way we are talking, these are all because of the genetic material we contain in our cells. Okay, that is the function of nucleus. We have seen the structure also in the previous class. Now today we are going to learn about some more organelle structure and their functions present in the cell. Let us see what are the organelles we are going to see now. Endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi complex, lysosomes, mitochondria. These are the organelles we are going to learn now. The learner going to learn from this lesson or conducts experiment to observe mitochondria in plant cells, explains the functions of endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi body, mitochondria, etc., observes inner parts of organelles and draws the diagrams of mitochondria, endoplasmic reticulum, gives reason for why does plant cell possess large sized vacuole, describes the structure of Golgi complex with the help of diagram. Okay children, these are the learning outcomes from this lesson. First, I want to explain to you about endoplasmic reticulum. What is endoplasmic reticulum? And what is the use of it in the cells or for the organism? Actually, endoplasmic reticulum is a membrane bound. It is a network of membranes observed throughout the cytoplasm. If you see in the picture, you will observe like this. Completely, it surrounds the nucleus in the cell. It is a network of membranes spread throughout the cytoplasm. What does endoplasmic reticulum do in cell? This is the network of membrane and transport different substances from one part to other part of the cytoplasm. Okay. If you observe this clearly, it contains different membranes, foldings and also the tubes. If you observe clearly, tubes and tubules present in this endoplasmic reticulum. Through these tubules and channels, it transports various types of substances. Based on its structure, endoplasmic reticulum is divided into two parts. One is rough endoplasmic reticulum and another one is smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Rough endoplasmic reticulum means the surface of endoplasmic reticulum is not smooth. It has some structures on it, over it. Because of that, we are treating it as rough endoplasmic reticulum. If you take smooth endoplasmic reticulum, the surface of it is smooth. So that is why we are calling it as smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, now I will show you the videos of rough and smooth endoplasmic reticulums. Now observe it carefully. See, these are the animal cells. Inside the animal cells, there are a lot of organelles present. Now you are observing endoplasmic reticulum, that is rough endoplasmic reticulum. What you are observing on the surface of it? A small spherical balls, isn't it? Those are called as ribosomes. That means endoplasmic reticulum contains on the surface of it called ribosomes, called rough endoplasmic reticulum. Then we will observe what is the difference between rough and smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Now observe the smooth endoplasmic reticulum structure. These are the animal cells or human cells. Inside it you will find a smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Observe it. Membrane bound structures with the tubes, lot of tubes you are observing, but its surface is smooth. There are no spherical balls, circular balls on the surface of it. Okay, children, so that is why it is called as smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Now we will observe what is the function of it. First, rough endoplasmic, what rough endoplasmic reticulum do in cell? On the surface of rough endoplasmic reticulum, I told you already, ribosomes present. What these ribosomes do? They synthesize proteins. Ribosomes synthesize proteins. These proteins are useful in building the cell membrane. Okay, cell membrane is made up of proteins and lipids. No? These proteins are useful for that purpose. And if it takes smooth endoplasmic reticulum, on the surface of smooth endoplasmic reticulum, there are no ribosomes present. What is the use of it? What smooth endoplasmic reticulum make? Proteins or lipids manufactured in this site. Okay, proteins or lipids produced in the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. These proteins and lipids, fats and lipids are produced in smooth endoplasmic reticulum. These lipids are useful in building the cell membrane. And the another one important function of smooth endoplasmic reticulum is this smooth endoplasmic reticulum present in the liver cells especially detoxifies poisons or drugs. Detoxify toxins, especially what is toxic? Toxic materials destroys our cells. Here a smooth endoplasmic reticulum, what smooth endoplasmic reticulum do? Detoxify. Detoxify means removing the toxic nature, which is harmful nature. That is, harmful nature is diluted by this smooth endoplasmic reticulum. That is what this smooth endoplasmic reticulum saves the cells from toxins. Okay? Right. This is about endoplasmic reticulum. Endoplasmic reticulum is a network of membranes which has tubes and tubules. It spread throughout the cytoplasm and it transport various kinds of materials required for the cell. Rough endoplasmic reticulum synthesizes proteins. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum synthesizes lipids or fats. These two are helpful in building cell membrane. And smooth endoplasmic reticulum detoxifying or diluting the toxins which are present in our body. How they enter into our body? While taking food or spoiled food, unknowingly if we eat any food which contains toxins, and also the medicines we took that contains some toxins, are detoxified by smooth endoplasmic reticulum. And now I am moving on to next important organelle, that is Golgi complex. The endoplasmic reticulum produces some proteins and lipids. Those are transported to this organelle. That organelle name is called as Golgi complex or Golgi body, and we call it as Golgi apparatus also. Golgi complex, Golgi body, Golgi apparatus also. And who found this organelle first? It was first discovered by Camillo Golgi. The scientist name is Camillo Golgi in the year 1898. And what is the structure of the Golgi complex? Observe it carefully. What you are observing? Some tube-like structures, isn't it? Tube-like structures, and at the end of the tube-like structures, you are observing some sacs, sac-like structures at the end of the tube, isn't it? Golgi complex or Golgi body made up of several membranes. These are all the membranes. These membranes create a sac-like structures. These are the sac-like structures around them. Okay. Proteins are transported to Golgi body, and here the proteins are slightly modified here, and they are packed into vesicles and transported to various parts which are required. Those are received from this Golgi complex. Okay, and the packed ones are in the vesicles like this. These are the vesicles produced by the Golgi body. These vesicles contains proteins or some other materials, and these vesicles transport those materials to the place where they require. Okay, and the important one about the Golgi complex is the number of Golgi bodies varies from cell to cell. Mostly Golgi bodies particularly is more number in glands. Do you know, children, what is gland? Gland is a group of tissue which are similar in structure and functions. They produces enzymes or hormones. They produces some chemicals. Especially based on the chemicals they produces and based on the structure of that gland, those are glands divided into two types, exocrine glands and endocrine glands. Exocrine glands have ducts. Through ducts, those chemicals transport from one part to another parts. And especially when we come to endocrine glands, those glands do not have ducts. The chemicals produced by those glands are directly released into blood. Blood transport those chemicals to where they function. Actually, the hormones are released by endocrine glands and the enzymes are released by exocrine glands. Enzymes helps in digestion and some other processes. Hormones controls various functions of our body, growth, our skin color, different functions, all of the functions in our body are controlled by hormones. Especially in these glands, Golgi complex number is more because they packs the different kinds of enzymes, hormones are released by the glands, and in these Golgi body also helps in the secretion of those hormones and enzymes. Okay, now I want to show you the structure of Golgi complex. Observe this video carefully. If you observe it carefully, these are the human cells. Inside the human cells, there are different organelles you are observing. Different kinds of organelles you are observing. Now, you are observing now the Golgi body. These are the different membranes. End of these membranes, you are finding some sacs. And these are the vesicles produced by the Golgi body. The round balls you are observing, those are called the vesicles are produced by the Golgi body. Those contains the materials modified in the Golgi complex especially. Okay, children, now I am moving on to another one interesting organelle, lysosomes. Lysosomes are also the organelles which present inside the animal body. Those are very tiny particles present inside the cytoplasm. They have especially some destructive enzymes. Because of these enzymes, there is no harm to the cell. But the materials which need to be destroyed are transported to lysosomes. Then they digested at times in lysosomes. The lysosome burst and enzymes are released to digest itself. So that means the waste materials, the harmful materials which are present inside the cell are transported to lysosomes. In lysosomes, there are enzymes present. That enzymes digest those waste materials or unwanted materials of a cell. And later those enzymes digest the lysosomes itself. Because of this, lysosomes are called as suicidal bags. That means they digest them themselves. So that is why we are calling them as suicidal bags, because of the enzymes present inside it digest the harmful materials and also the digest the organelle lysosome. Lysosome looks like this inside the cell. Okay, children. And I want to discuss about another one's organelle, which is useful in releasing energy for cell. Cell requires energy to perform various activities. That energy comes from another one organelle. That organelle is called as mitochondria. Mitochondria are the energy releasing organelle. Have you ever observed mitochondria, children? If you want to observe mitochondria, you have to do one lab activity. What is that lab activity? Now I will show you the video. In this video, my students are performing one lab activity. They are going to observe the mitochondria in onion peel cells. For this, we require Janus Green B solution. That is Janus Green B, Janus Green solution, water, watch glass, forceps, brush, glass light, glass cover slips, onion, razor, white paper or blotting paper or tissue paper in compound microscope. First, she is pouring some water and she is adding Janus Green solution to the water. You can make Janus Green B solution on your own. That is, take 100 ml of water and add 200 mg of Janus Green B to the water and mix it well. Then you can get the Janus Green B solution. What she is doing? She took the peel from the onion and placing that onion peel in the Janus Green solution. Mitochondria are stained by this solution. Because of that only we took. Take a clean glass slide and place the onion peel over the glass slide. Make sure there should not be any foldings in the onion peel. Place the cover slip over the onion peel and remove the excess water present on the slide with the help of blotting paper or white paper. And now observe it under microscope. If you have 100x lens, observe it through. Then you will find the mitochondria clearly. Okay, they looks like these. The green dots you are observing inside the onion peel cells are mitochondria. Okay, what we have to do? We have to write the lab activity record. Aim. What is our aim? To observe the mitochondria present in onion peel cells. Materials required: Janus Green solution, wash glass, brush, forceps, onion, compound microscope, paper, beaker with water. Procedure, what we had followed. First we made Janus Green bean solution and later we took the onion peel from the onion and placed the onion peel in the Janus Green solution. And later after a few minutes we took that peel from the solution and placed it on glass slide. And after that, we placed the glass cover slip over the onion peel. And later we observed that under microscope. And in observation, what the cells you are observed under microscope, you have to draw the sketch of it. And in the result, what you had observed under microscope, that you have to write in the result. Okay, children? And the interesting facts about mitochondria. The shape of mitochondria is spherical or cylindrical or oval in shape. They are very small in structure. We can see that the structure of microscope only with the electron microscope, internal structure, if you want to observe. Generally, mitochondria's length of mitochondria is 2 to 8 microns. In the wide is 0.5 microns wide. That means the mitochondria are 150 times smaller than nucleus. They are 150 times smaller than nucleus. There are about 100 to 150 mitochondria in each cell. Each cell contains 100 to 150 mitochondria in our body or living beings. When seen under compound microscope, the mitochondria appear as oval or cylindrical dots in cell. They appear like oval or cylindrical dots in the cells. The diagram of mitochondria, we can see that internal structure of mitochondria through electron microscope only. Okay, children, what is the function of mitochondria? In mitochondria, there are some chemicals present. In the presence of chemicals, oxygen oxidizes food materials. Because of that oxidation, oxygen releases energy from food because of that oxidation process in the mitochondria. That process occurs in especially these organelles in mitochondria. That is why we are calling the mitochondria as powerhouses. Power means energy. Energy is released here in these organelles. Because these organelles contain some particular chemicals. Especially if you observe its structure, this is the outer membrane and this is the inner membrane. Inner membrane has many foldings. These foldings called as cristae. Okay. Inside the mitochondria, there is a fluid present. That fluid part is called as matrix. This foldings is called inner membrane. This is outer membrane. Inner membrane, these foldings called cristae, and the liquid part present inside this membrane is called matrix. In this matrix area, on the cristae area, some chemicals are present. Those are helpful in respiration. Respiration means energy releasing process from food occurs here. That is why we are calling the mitochondria as powerhouses of the cell. Okay, children. Now I want to show you the video of the mitochondria. Observe it carefully. These are the mitochondria. Now we are going to see the structure and functions of it. These are the animal cells you are observing. Inside the animal cells, there are so many organelles present like nucleus, lysosomes, ribosomes. Mitochondria are called as powerhouses of cell because they are producing energy from food. You are observing the mitochondria. This one is in spherical shape and this one is elongated oval shape. If you observe its structure, this is the outer membrane. And these are cristae, the foldings. These inner foldings are called cristae. Inner membrane folds like this. Here in the cristae matrix, food oxidized and first forms as pyruvate or pyruvic acid. That pyruvic acid goes into another steps and produced finally ATP. ATP is the energy released in mitochondria. Matrix is filled with enzymes, coenzymes, water and other molecules. This is the matrix. You are observing the brown fluid. These are the sites of cellular respiration. I told you already, because of the enzymes present in it, respiration process takes place there and finally releases energy in the form of ATP. That ATP is utilized by us for doing different actions or functions. Okay, children, this is the structure and functions of the mitochondria. What we have seen up to yet, mitochondria are the powerhouses of the cell because of it. It produces energy for the cell. We have seen the structure and functions of cell organelles like endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi complex and mitochondria. And now I am moving on to evaluation part. Children, don't forget to write the answers for these questions. Write the answers for these questions and send those answers to your teacher. Okay. And what would, first question is, what would happen to cells if there were no Golgi bodies? What happens to the cells if there were no Golgi bodies? If you know the function of Golgi bodies, you can write the answer for this question. Golgi bodies modifies the proteins, lipids and other materials and packs them and transport them into various parts. Lysosomes are known as suicidal bags of the cell. Why? Why we are calling lysosomes as suicidal bags? They digest waste materials, dilutes waste materials, harmful materials and digest itself. So that is why we are calling lysosomes are suicidal bags. Draw a neat label diagram of mitochondria. Mitochondrion is singular. Write the procedure required to observe mitochondria in onion peel cells. We can also observe onion peels mitochondria in cheek cells and some other leaf cells also, like rheolic cells. What are the differences between rough endoplasmic reticulum and smooth endoplasmic reticulum? You know, I explained about this. Describe the structure of mitochondria with the help of diagram. Mitochondria, how many parts are present? What is the function of it? Okay. Why mitochondria are called as powerhouses of cell? Because cellular respiration occurs in mitochondria. Because Christian and stroma, sorry, matrix contains the chemicals, enzymes, coenzymes, water that their food oxidizes and produces energy. Because of that, we are calling the mitochondria as powerhouses of the cell. Okay, children? And now I am going to show you about the multiple choice questions which are useful for competitive exams, and also they are helpful in summative assessment exam also. Which one of the organelle is involved in repair and regeneration of cell membrane? Which of these organelles helpful for cell membrane regeneration? Lysosomes, ribosomes, Golgi body, endoplasmic reticulum. What is the correct one? Lysosomes are destructive enzymes. Ribosomes helps in protein synthesis. Golgi body packs various materials. Endoplasmic reticulum produces proteins as well as lipids also. So proteins and lipids useful in making cell membrane. So what is the correct answer? Endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, children. And the next one question is, identify the incorrect statement about endoplasmic reticulum. It is a network of membranes was observed throughout the cytoplasm. Yes, it is right. Endoplasmic reticulum have ribosomes on it called as RER, rough endoplasmic reticulum, right? Endoplasmic materials are not involved in building of plasma membrane. They are not involved in building of plasma membrane. Plasma membrane, cell membrane is same. Plasma membrane is also called as cell membrane. So actually endoplasmic materials involved in the building of plasma membrane. Here what they are saying, they are not involved in building of plasma membrane. Third one, C option. In invertebrate liver cells, smooth endoplasmic reticulum plays a crucial role in detoxifying many poisons or drugs. So what is the incorrect one here? C is the incorrect one. So answer is that one only. And next question, cell membrane is made up of proteins and cellulose, proteins and maltose, cellulose and maltose, proteins and lipids. Which one is correct, children? Proteins and lipids. So answer is D. And another one question, assertion and reasoning type of question. In NAS type of exams, National Achievement Survey, these type of questions they usually ask. Lysosomes are known as suicidal bags of cell. Statement is this. And the reasoning for this statement is, in a damaged cell, the lysosomes burst open and releases enzymes which digest their own cell. This is the reasoning for why lysosomes are called as suicidal bags. Both assertion and reasoning are correct. Both assertion and reasoning are incorrect. Assertion is incorrect, reasoning is correct. Assertion is correct and reasoning is incorrect. Which is correct one among these? Option A is correct. Both assertion and reasoning are correct. Isn't it, Chana? Yes. Find the odd one based on the structure of mitochondria. Which is not related to mitochondria? Cristae present in mitochondria? Yeah. Matrix? Yes. Outer membrane? Yes. Stroma? Stroma is not presented in mitochondria. It is presented in some other organelle. Okay. So, which is the odd one here? Stroma. Answer is D. Odd one means different one. These three are present in mitochondria, but this is not present in mitochondria. In the last one question, identify the correct pair based on the cell organelle and its function. Mitochondria, energy releasing organelle, ribosomes, lipid synthesis, endoplasmic reticulum, photosynthesis, nucleus, cells control room. Which are correct here? Mitochondria, energy releasing, that is correct. Ribosomes, lipid synthesis is right? No, this is wrong. Endoplasmic reticulum, photosynthesis? No. Nucleus, cells control room? Yes, right. That is means 1 and 4 are correct. 1 and 4 is in B option. So that is why B option is correct. Okay, children? Like this way we have to answer the multiple choice questions. Children, you have to try to make these type of multiple choice questions from the lesson. If you prepare these type of questions, means you will get the grip over the content. You will, okay, you have to prepare these type of questions. You will read the lesson more than 2 times, so then you will get a good idea over the concept. Okay, children, try to make these type of questions. And thanks for watching, and I will meet you again with another topic. Until then, bye everyone.